This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hi there, welcome to episode 8, Expanding Expressions with the FOIL Method. In this episode, we're going to learn how to multiply together two binomials with the FOIL method. Let's begin. So the problem I've given you here is to expand 2x minus 3y, the quantity squared. Now, if you didn't know the FOIL method, here's what you might be tempted to do. You may be tempted to say, well, 2 squared is 4, x squared is x squared, negative 3 squared is 9, and y squared is just y squared, but that's a trap. You don't want to do anything like this. What you have to do instead is to rewrite the expression as two terms rather than one squared term. So what you should be starting with is this. 2x minus 3y times 2x minus 3y written like this. So we have two terms with two things inside. And anytime you have two terms with two things inside, here and here, you have to use what's called the FOIL method. And the FOIL method will give you four terms, one for each letter, not two terms as we got in the trap answer up here at the top. What we have to do for the FOIL method is first multiply the first terms together, that is, this 2x with this 2x. Well, 2 times 2 is 4, and x times x is x squared. That's the first step. The second step is to multiply the outer terms together, that is, this 2x with this negative 3y. Well, let's do the numbers first, then the letters. 2 times negative 3 gives us negative 6, and x times y gives us xy. That takes care of the second step. Now we multiply the inner terms, that is, this negative 3y with this 2x. Well, handle the numbers first, then the letters. Negative 3 times 2 is again negative 6, and x times y is again xy. That takes care of the inner terms. Now for our final step, we multiply the last terms together. So we take this negative 3y times this negative 3y. Again, numbers first, then letters. Negative 3 times negative 3 gives us positive 9. And then y times y gives us y squared. And so we have four terms, not just two. That takes care of the last terms. Check that off. And so now our final step is to combine any like terms that we see. Well, we've got an x squared term here, and I don't see any more of those. We have a y squared term here. I don't see any more of those either. We have an xy term here, and then we have another xy term here. We can combine those two together because they have exactly the same letters. Negative 6 and negative 6 makes negative 12 xy, and the other terms stay the same. 4x squared stays the same, and 9y squared stays the same as well. And this is our final answer, and that's the FOIL method. So, the important thing is, if you see a polynomial that's squared, you can't just square everything inside of it. You have to rewrite it into two parentheses and then use the FOIL method in order to get the correct answer. Thank you very much for watching. We'll see you again next episode.